Hello there, everyone, and welcome to Joe's Bus Train Plane Lift Adventures here on YouTube. I hope you're all keeping well and staying safe during these dark times of the COVID-19 pandemic. And COVID-19, you probably might know, is coronavirus. And of course, 2020, which is the year that the pandemic had struck, has put a lot of lives at risk and has also stopped us doing stuff what we love doing. And it has been such a disappointment to all of us. But anyway, let's head to the video. Now, you can probably tell on the video why I've got Beatties up. Now, as you probably know, Beatties, which is the flagship store in Wolverhampton, is sadly going to close down. So, I could give you a lot of history about the store before showing you the store inside itself. So, Beatties was a small British department store group located primarily in the Midlands of England. And then in the year 2005, when it had 12 stores, the group was acquired by House of Fraser. And of course, I'll show you the House of Fraser logo later on in the video. On 14th of January 2006, since House of Fraser took over the Rackham store, the Birmingham store on Corporation Street had to close because it was in competition with the House of Fraser that was Rackham's. And that site was developed into a JJB Sports that closed in 2012 and Mothercare that recently closed just before the pandemic. Only New Look is the original store since it taken over the BT site, which used to also be occupied by C&A, which was another big chain of department stores. In August 2007, the Telford store was rebranded along with the Solihull and Sutton Coldfield stores. The group was gradually rebranding all its branches under the House of Fraser name, but sadly, in January 2010, the Dudley branch, which was the only Beatties store across most parts of the Black Country and the only Beatties store in the Samwell and Dudley region, had to close because the company was no longer viable to trade in Dudley. As you probably know, that Beatties was such a good store. It had really nice Otis escalators, but sadly, the Otis escalators kept breaking down all the time. The lift there, which used to be an Otis hydraulic, got modernised. However, that only remained with the store until it closed in 2010. The downstairs location was closed, and I'm going to give you an update on the downstairs location in Wolverhampton. Then in 2018, the last branch that retained the name Beatties, which was the former head office in Wolverhampton, was to close in 2019. Former Beatties branded House of Fraser stores in Aylesbury, Birkenhead, Telford, and also a branch in Worcester's Crowngate Shopping Centre were also announced to close. However, despite the CVA, the owner of Sports Direct, Mike Ashley, started saving stores on the basis whether they could rent to achieve a specific margin. The Telford branch proposed closure was repealed on the 23rd of August 2018. The first to be repealed. And as of December 2018, all Beatties stores currently trading are announced to be remained open. The company Beatties was formed in 1887 and was founded by James Beatty. And Beatties was one of these best known stores to come. Beatties sold everything from toys to meat to furniture to all the clothing before the designer products came and many more. Anyway, let's crack on. So then, House of Fraser, which is the name we know today, had taken over the Beatties stores back in the 20th century. Along with the Wolverhampton store, which was Beatties' former head office and is closing, House of Fraser will still continue with the ex-Beatties stores that have survived. They are Aylesbury in Buckinghamshire, Huddersfield in West Yorkshire, Solihull in the West Midlands just by Birmingham, Sutton Coldfield in the West Midlands north of Birmingham, Telford in Shropshire, and Worcester in Worcestershire. The former stores, which did not survive, was of course the centre of Birmingham on Corporation Street, because it was in competition with the one that was Rackham's, Burton-on-Trent in Staffordshire, which is now a Poundland, Dudley, which has now become an Iceland frozen food chain, Northampton and in Northamptonshire, which is now a Nexton Primark, and also the branch in Birkenhead. And that was all the BT stores that were trading under the House of Fraser banner. So anyway, let's crack on and do the tour of this awesome department store. So then, let's crack on. So anyway, here we are at BT's Wolverhampton. And this is not the main part of the store. This was an extension that was introduced in the late 1990s. Which was 1997 when the store had an expansion. And you probably know this had an additional basement area called street level. And this was where the furniture department was located. But then a few years on, after House of Fraser took over BT's, the furniture department moved upstairs to the ground floor, and the street level just completely closed down. And then later they opened up street level for a clearance department. But now the downstairs area where the clearance department was has been closed down and onwards until the announcement today that BT's was going to close in Wolverhampton. It's such a shame because this downstairs street level was so accessible. But however, you could still walk down to street level by using the staircase just located in that tower on my far left. So then, we have just now gone into BT's, one of the best known department stores, which is set to close down. So here we are on street level, which was where the furniture department was. As you can see, this area is now derelict. And this has been derelict ever since and will be like that since the shop is going to be closing down. It's going to be such a shame to say goodbye to this iconic department store. It has been one of my favourite department stores across the centre of Wolverhampton. So the only BT's I'll be able to go is Telford, Solihull, Sutton and Sutton Coldfield, and even the one in Worcester. And but however, they're not the same as this iconic BT's department store, because this one was one of the best known department stores in the country that I like so much. Then it was a bit like a Harrods back in the day when you had food on the older basement area, which I'll come to later on in the video. So anyway, this is now looking derelict now. The lower ground floor, well, not really street level, because the lower ground floor is in the old part of the store. So anyway, let's move on to the ground floor. So then, I have now taken the stairs up to the main ground floor where all the people are bustling around the store. And this is one of the last remaining parts of the store that's still open. And this floor is for the soft furnishings. And well, not much anymore. And also, this was where Toy Town was when the BT's returned the toy department. However, the toys did not last long because basically toys were getting dated with BT's. So you can see quite a lot of empty areas. As you can see, the place is now getting run down. It's such a shame to say goodbye to this iconic store. So anyway, here's another look where the toys used to be here in BT's Wolverhampton. Such a shame that this area is now getting abandoned, and shame that the store is set to close down. As you probably also know, that on the ground floor there used to be an audiovisual department. As you probably know, it was like televisions and hi-fi stuff. But sadly, that is now finger the past now, because all the TVs and the hi-fi systems have now completely disappeared. So then, carrying on along the ground floor and the area where the lighting section used to be, and these days it's been turned into like a small kind of a toy concession, which is not really brilliant compared to the original toy department that was below. And this is only an area for like coming up to Christmas. And you can see there's some Christmas trees, as you probably know. Beatty's is so good for Christmas, but sadly Christmas won't be with Beatty's this year, so it'll be such a sad time to say goodbye to this popular department store, and such a sad time. So anyway, you got a board game, Golden Rings, presented by this morning's television presenter, Philip Schofield. And Golden Rings has been such a popular TV show on the chat on every UK television. Of course, you've got Strictly Come Dancing, which is a popular BBC show. It's been on BBC One ever since, and you can probably see here one of the famous games that everyone would like to buy for those people who like watching Strictly on telly. Of course, you've got Party Game Blockbuster Video, which was a chain that went bust back in 2013, along with HMV Jessop's, and Jessop's and HMV have survived since 2013's administration. HMV has been going downhill quite a few times, and it's been quite a shock. And as you can see, this was the entrance to the old sweets and cards department. That area is now looking abandoned now. It will be abandoned since the shop is closing down. I used to love going through the sweets and the cards department, and this became part of a Yankee Candle. As you can see, the cards have now moved into this area of the store. Not as popular as the original cards department that was in the store. And as you know, BT's was really good with the cards department, being in the original spot, as it was even closer to the exit part to the high street. So anyway, here's the MT department where the cards used to be, and there's the exit doorway, the X doorway that goes towards the sweets department. And here's another abandoned floor. Don't know what this was. Maybe, possibly the opticians or the ticket office, because I remember when Beatty's used to have a ticket office as well. And they even used to have the bookshop department, if you also remembered. And Beatty's was such a lovely department store to be honest. So then we have now moved from the ground floor to the first floor, which is another main floor. And again, this area is still bustling, and this is the shoe department. Years ago, we used to have the children's shoe department. As you probably remembered, I used to come here quite a few times to get new shoes, which was really popular. It was under a brand called Clarks. And of course, just round the corner from the shoe department was the interactive playboat. I used to love playing on that interactive playboat with all the different buttons. But sadly, the boat got stripped out just as the children's shoe department was quitting the store, and it's now expanded into a ladies' shoe department. Of course, you probably know that there is a lot of good fans here, which is very, very interesting. But however, people may think that children would climb onto the fans and make them spin round, but anyway, I don't think they've done that, because obviously they're a bit too shorter to climb on. But however, it is one of the best known stores, I have to say, BT's. It was one of the best ones. So anyway, we're in the women's wear department of the store. So anyway, let's go up now to the second floor. We have now reached the second floor, the top floor in this awesome BT's department store. Now, as you probably know, the top floor is where the menswear is located. And the menswear department has been so popular with Beatty's department store and all the good designers. And as you probably also know, this is also where the restaurant used to be. And the restaurant used to open up into this area right here before they shrunk it. And nowadays, this area is covered by Sports Direct. So anyway, here is the Cafe Zest restaurant. Well, not anymore, because all the furniture has been stripped out. Tables and chairs are gone. The kitchen is now looking derelict. And this part is now abandoned. So there is no longer a restaurant up here. But still, you can go through up into this area, which I'll show you in a minute. So, as you know, on the third floor was the regional training centre. Well, not anymore. It probably won't be there for a while now, because the store is just about to close down. And also there is payphones, well, telephones, just right on this end, just right here at the store. And such a shame that they're going to close this iconic store, because it's been one of my favourite stores that I've been to in Wolverhampton, and it will be missed by me most of all. So then, that was the end of the tour of the store. Now, let's look at the lifts in the store. Now, I have not got videos of the lifts in this store in this video, but however, click the links below to watch the lifts in the store done by me and Jim Woodward 1212. So anyway, here is the first lift. This was the really nice, awesome old Otis lift. But a few years ago, this lift got modernised with Dewhurst fixtures, and even the floor indicators was modernised. And this lift went from the second floor down to the lower ground floor, which is now abandoned. And that was where the toy department was located. And it opened later as a clearance clothing outlet for like all the clothing that needed to be sold off, and even a grotto for Christmas, as Beatty's was so popular with the grotto, which was the iconic Santa's grotto. But sadly, you won't have that anymore, because this store is now closing for the final time. And so anyway, here is the old Otis lift. So anyway, here's another lift. This one actually accesses via Darlington Street, and it's tucked away, but when I went to the store last time, this lift was out of order. And anyway, here is another lift in the store. This one goes between the ground floor and the Beatty's restaurant, and even goes up to the management offices and the business centre. So anyway, there's the other lift, the out of order one. This one used to go to the lower ground floor, so there was only three lifts that went down to the main lower ground floor, including this one. And the tour department was so popular when it was on the lower ground floor, but sadly, that area is now closed off. Of course, there's no photos of the escalators here. The escalators here are all Owen Kayleigh's, two that go between each floor. Anyway, let's move on to another lift. This one's quite smaller than the last first one. This one used to be an Otis, but got modernised by ThyssenKrupp. It used to have an announcement, but sadly, it got disconnected a few years ago, and this goes from the lower ground floor to the second floor. And anyway, moving on to the extension part, to the glass lift, which is an Otis 2000. It used to go from the first floor down to street level, and street level was yet again the furniture department. Was once again, yeah, the furniture department, if you hadn't heard previously. So now move on to the car park lift. This used to be an express modernised by ThyssenKrupp with glass doors. And this one has been one of the popular lifts that I've known in the store. So let's move out to the car park. So as you probably know, this had children's cartoon on the front. But not anymore, because it's all gone dull and white. So there's not much interest to this car park than it used to be, but the only interest is these old signs with the Beatty's logo on. As you know, Beatty's has been so popular. Here we are parked on level 6 of the shop itself. So anyway, that was the best video yet. So thank you very much for watching. This department store will be missed. And let's all reflect on all these good memories of Beatty's. Cue the credits.
Everybody's changing and I don't feel right.